gross anatomy about the liver. It's the largest gland of the body, which has a both endocrine and exocrine part. Usually it is a brownish in color. Weight wise, in a male, the average weight of the liver, it is about 1.5 kg. In a female, it is around 1 kg average weight. So it is the largest gland of the body. Okay, gross anatomy wise, today we will learn about the surfaces, border of the liver. After that, lobes of the liver, anatomical lobes, physiological lobes, relations of the livers, ligaments of the livers. So starting with the surfaces and the borders, usually liver has a two surface, diaphragmatic surface and visceral surface. Diaphragmatic surface divided into anterior surface, superior surface, right lateral surface, posterior surface, and okay, so these are the diaphragmatic surface, and this one is the most inferior part. It is a visceral surface. That is the visceral surface. Border wise, only the inferior border, it is a well defined border in the liver which separates the diaphragmatic surface from the visceral surface. Location wise, liver, it is situated in the right hypochondrium, upper part of the epigastric region, and left hypochondrium. Okay. Notable features of the surfaces wise, which are the notable features? So diaphragmatic surface, it is usually covered by with the diaphragm. Anterior surface of the liver, which has a notable features, this one is the falciform ligament. Falciform ligament, which divides the liver into two parts, right lobe and left lobe. Right lobe, it is a 6 times bigger as compared to the left lobe. Superior surface, which is also covered by the diaphragm. Right lateral surface, also covered with the diaphragm. Posterior surface, notable features of the posterior surface of the liver. This one is the bare area of the liver, which is covered by the coronary ligaments, upper layer and lower layer of the coronary ligaments. Right triangular ligaments is situated at here, which is the extension of the coronary ligaments, or you can say that it is actually the fold of peritoneal fold. Caudate lobe, quadrate lobe, left lobe, and here that is the left triangular ligament. Fossa for the gallbladder, pota hepatis, groove for the ligamentum venosum, fissure for the ligamentum teres hepatis, and this one is the inferior vena cava, the part of inferior vena cava. So in anatomical position wise, this is the correct anatomical position of the liver, in which the inferior vena cava, the opening of the vena cava should remain straight and directed upwards and remain straight directed upwards. That is the correct anatomical position of the liver. Anatomical lobes of the liver, which is divided by this falciform ligament. This one is the falciform ligament, which divides the liver into right larger lobe and left smaller lobe. Posteriorly, there are 4 lobes anatomical lobes wise. Again, right lobe, left lobe, upper part, that is the caudate lobe, and this one is the quadrate lobe. Caudate lobe and quadrate lobe, the boundary wise, one side it is covered by the groove or the fossa for the inferior vena cava. This one is the groove for the ligamentum venosum, fissure for the ligamentum teres hepatis, and this one is the fossa for the gallbladder. So these are the anatomical lobes, right, left, caudate and quadrate lobes. Another classification of the lobes of the liver is functional classification, physiological lobes or the true lobes. It is divided by one imaginary line that join the inferior vena cava, groove for the inferior vena cava, up to the fossa for the gallbladder. This imaginary line, or it is also known as a Cantley's plane or Cantley's line, that divides the liver into two parts, right lobe and left lobe. That is the physiological lobe or the true lobes. Now, liver contains so many segments, hepatic segments. Usually there are 8 hepatic segments are there, but it is not well defined as compared to the bronchopulmonary segments of the lungs. So during the surgical resection or the partial hepatectomy, the physiological lobe or the true lobes are considered during the surgery, because hepatic segments, there are 18 numbers hepatic segments, but it is not usually well defined. Okay. After the surfaces and border, that is the, this one is the inferior border and anatomical lobes, we will move forward regarding the relations and ligaments. Before going to the relations, which are the ligaments related with the livers? There are two varieties of the ligaments that related with the livers: false ligaments and true ligaments. Which are the false ligament? Falciform ligament. Here there is a coronary ligaments, the two layer of the coronary ligaments on posterior aspect of the right lobes. Then it is extended as a right triangular ligament, then left triangular ligament. These are the false ligament, and it is the usually it is a peritoneal folds. Which are the true ligaments of the liver? Here there is a ligamentum venosum. This is a groove for the ligamentum venosum, and this one is the fissure for the ligamentum teres hepatis. These two are the true ligaments. Okay, so this true ligaments, it is the remnant of the fetal structure. Ligamentum venosum, it is a remnant of obliterated part of ductus venosus, and ligamentum teres hepatis, it is a remnant of obliterated left umbilical vein. So these two structures are the true ligaments, and it is a remnant of fetal structure. And false ligaments are the peritoneal folds. These falciform ligaments, which connect the liver anteriorly to the anterior abdominal wall up to the umbilicus, and superiorly that connects the liver to the diaphragm. Posterior aspect, the two layer of the coronary ligament, upper layer and the lower layer of the coronary ligament. Upper layer that is reflected from the diaphragm up to the liver, and the lower layer that reflected from the liver up to the renal, right kidney, which extended as a right triangular ligament. And here there is a left triangular ligament. This is the part of the left triangular ligament. Okay, so these are the false and true ligaments of the liver. After that, the relations of the liver, anterior surface or anterior relations of the liver. So falciform ligament, which connect the liver to the anterior abdominal wall up to the umbilicus. So anterior surface of the liver, that is related to the geophoid process and anterior abdominal wall. Superior surface of the liver, which is related with the diaphragm, which is totally covered with the diaphragm. So right lobe, superior surface of the right lobe, that is connected with the right lungs and the pleura above. The central tendon of the diaphragm, that is connected on the central part of the superior surface, which separates the liver from the pericardium of the heart. This one is the right lateral surface. Now this right lateral surface, it is extended from the 7th rib up to the 11th ribs. So upper 1/3 portion of the right lateral surface, which is related with the lungs along with the pleura. Remember that lungs, it is extended up to the 8th rib. So middle 1/3 part of the right lateral surface, which is related with the costo-diaphragmatic recess, recess of the pleura. Okay. And lowermost part, that is related with the 10th and 11th ribs. So usually whenever the liver biopsy is the required, we have to do the needle inserted from 9th and 10th intercostal space to prevent the injury to the lungs on upper part of the upper 1/3 part of the right lateral surface of the liver. So remember that liver biopsy should be taken from the 9th or 10th intercostal space to prevent the injury to the lungs on upper part. So these are the relations of the right lateral surface. Okay. Relations on the posterior surface and inferior surface, or you can say this one is the visceral surface. Posterior surface relations wise, this one is the right lobes. So upper part of the right lobes on posterior surface, it is related with the right suprarenal gland along with the right renal impressions. usually this one is the bare area of the liver, because which is directly by connected by the upper and lower layer of the coronary ligament. So this one is the bare area. Which are the another bare areas of the livers? So first thing, that is the posterior surface of the right lobes. Second, fossa for the gallbladder. Fossa below this gallbladder, this one is the gallbladder. So fossa for the gallbladder, groove for the inferior vena cava, that is the groove for the inferior vena cava, groove for the ligamentum venosum. These are, and the porta hepatis, these are the usually bare areas of the liver. Now the relations wise, posterior inferior surface from this left lobe up to the inferior surface, posterior inferior surface, subsequently it is related with here on the most upper part of the posterior surface of the left lobe, it is esophageal impression related with the esophagus. After that, this all surfaces are posterior inferior surface related with the gastric impression, fundus of the stomach. Subsequently, this quadrate lobe, that is related with the duodenal impression or pyloric impression. After the pyloric impression, the duodenum moves forward, and it is related at here, duodenal impressions. Lowermost part of the inferior surface, it is a colonic impression, that is related with the colonic impressions. Okay, so these are the relations on posterior inferior surface: esophageal impression, gastric impression, pyloric impressions, after that duodenal impression, and lowermost part, that is related with the colonic impression. And moving towards the posterior surface, posterior inferior surface of the right lobes, this one is the right kidney, related with the right kidney or right renal impression, and uppermost part, that is with the right suprarenal impressions. So these are the impressions on posterior inferior surface, or you can say that this is the visceral surface, because the visceras are related: gastric, viscera, esophagus, stomach, pylorus, then duodenum and colon, and this one is the kidney and suprarenal gland. So these are the visceral impressions. Okay. So this is the all about the gross anatomy of the liver. Important part, this one is the porta hepatis. Porta hepatis, some structures are going towards the porta hepatis and some structures are leaving from the porta hepatis. So which are the structures goes into the liver through the porta hepatis? Because porta hepatis, it is also known as a gateway of the liver. So hepatic artery, branches of the hepatic artery, right and left hepatic vein, these are the veins. After that, the artery, right and left branches of the hepatic artery, hepatic veins, and right and left branches of hepatic duct. These are the structures present in the porta hepatis. Now remember that hepatic veins and hepatic arteries going inside the porta hepatis, and hepatic ducts comes out from the porta hepatis. So this one is the porta hepatis, and the margin of the porta hepatis, it is attached with the lesser sac or the lesser omentum. This one is the gallbladder. So this is the all about the lobes, surfaces, borders, relations, physiological lobes, true lobes, and peritoneal ligaments of the liver. Thank you.